Afternoon. Get started with your seeing at your outside. You can hear the music alright, it's not too loud. So today we're doing a mix of six exercises. We're going to do them three times. 40 second exercises, 20 second rest, okay? Then we're gonna do a bit of hip mobility at the end, okay? So we'll do our nice exercises, six of them, three times, get through all those, do a little bit of pelvic floor as well with our stretching, and then we're gonna do some hip mobility stretches, okay? So really, really good for postnatal, especially all three postnatal or anyone who's doing exercise, hip mobility exercises are really useful. So I'll have a bit of a chat about that and I will just show you six stretches at the end. All right, so afternoon, let me know if you're on and we will get started real soon. I'm just gonna give it a few minutes because the notifications take a little bit of time to come through. Make sure you've got some water. Some weights for today's exercises. We're going to get started in about one more minute. So just let everyone log on. So you need weights today, water, sun cream if you're outside like me. We're gonna get started really, really soon. Give it one more minute and we will get going, okay? Just make sure you've got everything that you need. It's a nice breeze today, not like Wednesday when it was boiling. Okay, we're gonna get started. So first things first, marching on the spot. So welcome to the 0-6, week seven. So we're taking it up each week, slowly and steady, just bit by bit, working our way up and getting everything stronger, okay? Now, make sure that you are, if you are starting this session, that you need to have had your GP check. You're over at least 6 weeks for a normal birth. If you had any complications at all with your birth and you need to double check for a cesarean, it's after 12 weeks and you need to check with your health provider if you are ready to exercise, okay? As always, if you feel any heaviness or pulling in your pelvis, then I want you to stop. If you feel dizzy at any point, then you must stop as well, okay? So those things are the really important stuff. You can see all the details on the Babi Active page where you can see if you are ready to start exercising. So we're gonna go into our light squats in 3, 2, 1, off we go. So just nice and gentle, we're not going very far at all. Getting those arms involved. Enjoying that sunshine, hopefully, if you're outside. Four, three, two, and one. Okay, step back into the lunge, just doing those warm-up ones. Down we go. Now if that is too much, bring your legs closer together and just drop down. Okay. So you're going to be getting any pelvis pain, please do that. 7 seconds. Keep going, make sure the shoulders are back. Lovely. And swap legs. Brilliant. Keep going with this one, okay? We're getting nice and warm for those exercises. So it's going to be 6 exercises, 3 times today. 40 seconds per exercise, 20 seconds rest in between. Wrist rotations for me, and then we're going to have a minute's rest in between each block of 6 exercises. Okay, and the other way. Just make sure you're getting those wrists nice and warm. Hi, Anwen. Lovely, okay, arm rotations now. So I want soft knees on this one, and we're going to go forwards. Get your shoulder nice and mobile. And backwards. That's it, then we're going to do a little bit of glute activation as well. Okay, so just some side steps for me. So feet together, soft knees, put that bum back, hands on hips if that's the most comfortable place, and step together, step together. Okay, and then back the other way. Good. Sit. Okay. Now we're going to do some squats where we go a little bit lower. So I want you to just squat down and tap the floor if you can. So it's down, reach up. We're going to do 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Lovely. All right, we're going to get on with our stretching now. So just really, really quick, stretch out those calves first of all. So that back leg nice and straight. Pressing down into that back heel. And then swap over. I'm loving this weather. I know I talk about weather quite a lot on these workouts. It's very important in lockdown, isn't it? Okay, quick hamstring. Toes up, heel down. Push that bum back. Make sure this back is nice and flat and you're feeling it down the back of this straight leg. Other leg's got a slight bend in it. Looking forwards. And swap legs. Okay, quick one with the arms. We're gonna go forwards. So interlock those fingers, pushing them forwards, opening that chest up. So that back up, chest is the next one. That's it. Okay, and then backwards. So hands at your bottom, interlink them, and then lift up. And then I want you to lift that chest as well and look up. Just slightly, really opening that chest up. Okay, give the shoulders a little bit of a roll after that and a little bit of a roll forwards. Right, we're going to get into the main workout now, all right? So, make sure. First one we're going to do, we need one weight, okay? So all you need, one weight, can be whatever it is. So whatever you're using as your weight, please grab it, okay? Now we're going to do a holding squat, but we're not going to go very far. We're going to have our toes out and we're just going to go down into the holding squat slightly. I'm hardly going into a squat here, okay? And we're going to just press with that one side. Just press, okay? 20 seconds on the one side and then we're going to go on to the other side. And every time you lift that weight up, I want you to lift your pelvic floor at the same time, okay? Which means we're going to breathe out. So we breathe in and then breathe out. With that small lift as we're doing it, okay? So we're going in 3, 2, 1, off we go. Lovely. 20 seconds. So we're just having that slight bend, lowering that bum slightly, lifting that pelvic floor as we are pushing the weight up, okay? Single arm shoulder press, keeping nice and balanced. Breathing out as you come up, engaging that core. And swap shoulders. That's it, okay? Make sure those knees aren't going over toes. You can see I'm not going very low at all with this one. It. The girls in the 6 month plus class will be going lower on Wednesday. If you feel like you can go lower, then please do. Lovely. Right, we're doing good mornings now. So, weight down, you don't need that, but we're going to do single leg. So I want you to put one leg back and your heel and your toe are in line. Okay, so you've got that slight bend, you've got the straight back leg, slight bend. Hands across your chest and we go down. And back up. Okay? 3, two, one. Off we go. Lift that heel up, down, and back up. So you'll be feeling it in this glute here. Down. This back leg is just there to support you. Down. Breathe out as you come back up. Okay, swap sides. Is that supporting you, remember? The slight bend. Make sure they're in line. And off we go. That's it. You'll really feel that in that glute then. And you'll feel it in your hamstring as well. We're not going fast. One more on this side. Lovely. Okay, so we're doing a squat with knee to elbow now. So, nice and wide. We squat down, we come up, together, together. Okay, so if you've got any pulling on any scars, please don't do the knee to elbow, just do the normal squats. Off we go. Squat, together. That's it. Brilliant work. Keep going at your pace, your speed, however you feel that is, okay? Just make sure it's the right level for you, especially in this heat at the moment. And if you're doing the catch up in the evening, same goes, okay? Breathing out as you come up. Five, four, three, two, and one. Well done. Okay, next exercise. We're doing stepping out star jumps, okay? Nice and steady. So normally, a star jump, you would be nice and active like this. We are not doing that. We're starting here and we're gonna go step, step, arms, step, step, in, step, step, arms, okay? Off we go. Step, step, arms, back in. That's it. Nice and dynamic as you do it. So you still get that heart rate up, you're still gonna get that pace up. Breathing out as you step out. That's it. Pick up the pace if you can. There's no stopping. You come in, you go back out. That's it. Doing that quick step, good. If that's too much, just step it slower. And if you are getting closer to that 6 month mark and you feel like you can add the little jump in, please do, but always remember, listen to that pelvic area. Okay, we're going down onto the floor. So we're doing a chest, we're doing a press up, be it a box or a half plank into child's pose. So I did this a few weeks ago. If you're doing box, you're in this position. You press, you come back up, you go back, and then you repeat. And if you're in half plank, so again, if you're past, you're out of that fourth trimester, you're feeling that your core is getting stronger. Only if your core is feeling stronger, you engage your core, you breathe out, and then back. Okay, so we're going in 3, 2, 1, off we go. I'm gonna do box. Nice, just nice and steady. Make sure you're getting that child's pose in. So we go all the way back. Give those arms a bit of a rest. Getting those glutes involved and those upper legs. Remember, only do that half plank press if you are feeling strong enough in your core. If you are not, this is still as beneficial. There we are. 5 seconds. Lovely. Okay, we're now doing arm raises on all fours. And again, this is the same. If you want to do it in a box position or you want to do it in a half plank, all depending on how strong your core is. So half plank position is like this. Make sure you're not dropping down like this or up too high. You need a nice straight line. Engage that core. Arms up. Or in that box position. Nice 4-point kneeling, okay? Make sure you've got a gap between your knees. Nice and stable. The closer your knees are together, the more wobbly you'll be. So you want that nice, stable stance. Breathing out as you lift up, drawing that core in. Well done, everyone. 3, two, and one. Okay, nice minutes rest now. Get a drink. Coming up standing, roll those wrists out if you need to, okay? Make sure you've got a nice, you've got a nice icy one today. Lovely. Loads of time. So, I will keep repeating the fact that you need to make sure that your core is ready for those exercises. And that's really hard at the moment because we're not able to see you in class, we're not able to help you with that. But if you have been following the programme bit by bit, listening to our advice, then you'll be getting there slowly but surely, okay? Just always make sure that you're not getting doming in your tummy still. That's talked about a lot in pregnancy fitness, but it also happens postnatally. So you need to make sure that that doming isn't there and that your core can take the pressure that you're putting on if you're going into a half plank. And if it can't, please don't do it. Go into that box position. It's really important that you listen to your body. Right, one weight. I'm a bit slow. We're going to go into a holding squat with a shoulder press. In 3, 2, 1. Off we go. Toes pointing out. Down into the holding squat and press. That's it. Straight up, back down. Controlled. Engaging that core, breathing out. Lifting that pelvic floor if you can as well, okay? Lovely. One more. And swap sides. Off we go. Lovely. It's nice with the split when you do one side and the other. We do a lot of single arm work as a new mum. Lots of holding baby in one arm, doing everything else with the other. So it's good to isolate them. Okay, we're back to those good mornings. So what I really want is this back leg, remember, it is just your balancing though. It can come up, but we're not going to do that in this class. Slight bend in this one. You want your toes and your heels in line, okay? And we're going to go down, two, hands across, off we go. Flat back. Back up. You feel it in that glute. Good. Try and make sure they're one, as close to one behind the other as you can. And swap sides. That's it, everyone. You'll be feeling it in that glute. Well done. Okay, squat with knee to elbow now. So I want nice and low, making sure that we can get really good cardio in this one, okay? So 10 seconds and we're gonna go nice and strong. So, toes out. Ready for those elbows to knee. Opposite sides we're gonna do today. And off we go. Squat down, together. Squat down, together. Squat down, together. Good. 10 seconds gone already at this one. That's it. Your elbow knee don't need to touch. Mine aren't touching. Brilliant work. 20 seconds. Okay, we're nearly halfway through the exercise of today. It is warm. That's it. As low as you can go, knee to elbow. This is your cardio point. 3, 2, 1. Lovely. Okay, step in star jumps. We're gonna go into this. Remember your pace. Now, you can pick it up. I'm going to be picking it up this time. So we've got 10 seconds. I'm going to step it out. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Off we go. So step, step, arms back in. Don't stop. That's it. Making sure you're getting that pace. You're stepping it. Step as wide as is comfortable for you. If it's too much pressure on your pelvis, don't step as far. That's it. Once you get a rhythm, it's there. That's it. Come on. If I don't look down, I'm all right. Once it's been drummed into you forever how to do a star jump, once you then go to the regress one, it's a bit harder. That's it. One more. Excellent. Right, we're doing press up in box or half into child's pose. Down onto the mat. If you need more more support under your knees, fold your mat over. Now, I'm going to go into a half this time because I did it in a box last time. So you've seen it in a box, half. Breathing out as you come up, back into child's pose. Okay, nice and smooth. That's it. And again, as always, if that's too much, go into that box press. Down, nose down, back up, bum back. Nice, well done. Keep going. Press ups aren't easy, whichever version you're doing. Lovely. Okay, we're going to go into arm raises now. So again, it's either the plank or the box for these, whichever one you feel is best for you at this stage of your recovery. So I'm going to go box this time. I'm going in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Knees under hips, hands under shoulders. Off we go. Draw that core back in. Really draw that core in for me. Not just belly button spine, that's not what I'm just talking about. We want that whole core corset coming back in. Breathing out as you do it. Nearly there, 12 seconds to go on this one. Remember, drop those hips if you want to go into that half. Engage that core. Lovely, okay, you've got that 1 minute rest now, okay? So we're gonna do a nice 1 minute rest. Just taking it easy. Nice and steady, okay? Nice and steady, get water on. Make sure that you are just rolling those wrists out if you can. We're on them for the press ups and for those arm raises, so roll those wrists out. Give the shoulders a bit of movement from those press ups as well. Okay, we're gonna go in 25 seconds, back into the squats with the shoulder press. And grab your weight, no matter what it is. If it's actually a dumbbell, that's amazing. If not, if it is a can of beans, that's absolutely fine. We're going into the last round now, okay? So it is less than 5 minutes work. Toes point now. Hand on the other waist, keep it nice and balanced. Breathe in and out. Down into the holding squat. Press. Press. Breathing out as you go. Engaging that pelvic floor as you press up if you can. So breathing out and lifting that pelvic floor. So it's not about how many reps you're doing, it's how strong they are. That's it. And swap sides. Straight into it. Make sure those knees aren't coming over your toes, pushing that bum back, not leaning forwards, chin up, that's it, come on. Gonna make this last round really count. 3, 2, 1, lovely, okay. Single leg good mornings. So again, it's just really important to get as much out of these as possible, which is why I talk about the form all the time. Make sure that your toe and your heel are in line. Remember this back leg is just for balance. Hands across and we go down. Back up. Okay, you'll feel it in that glute. Just bend in this front leg. Toe, off we go. There we go. Okay. That back leg is just for balance. That's it. If you are finding it a bit harder, make sure there's a larger gap between your feet. Flat back all the time. Swap legs. Quick as you can. And straight into it. Lovely. You might be thinking, doesn't look like much. When you engage that core, you keep that back flat, you'll really feel it in those glutes. Okay, one more. Breathing out as you come up, really bracing that core to bring you back up so your back doesn't dip. Okay, we're doing squats with knee to elbow, nice like cardio. And then we're going into those star steps. And we're going in 3, 2, 1, off we go. So squat together, squat together, opposite sides. That's it, lovely. I love these. There's so many variations as well. You can really make them work for you. Breathe out as you come up. That's it, come on everyone. 12 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Lovely, okay, step in star jumps in 20 seconds. So remember with these, get that pace right, get the rhythm, and don't think about it too much. Right, we're going in 5 seconds. I'll try not to think about it too much as well. Off we go. Okay, you can do single arms. That's another thing to think about. As quick as you can do it, okay? Pick up the pace if you can. That's it. My heart rate is high, considering. That's it, keep going with these. No one can see you doing them, don't worry. 2, and last one, done. Well done, okay. Press up into child pose. Remember, box or half plank, whatever is right for you. And always try and brace that core. Make sure you are ready to be doing the half planks if you are. I'm gonna do a demo half plank for 2 and then go into box. So you would go down, back. Okay, breathing out as you come up. Otherwise, go into that box position. Down, nose down, up, into child's pose. That's it, everyone. Keep going with these. Feel really nice on your back as you go into that child's pose. We're just swinging into it and coming straight back out though. Make sure those toes are tucked under. Lovely, okay, last exercise, arm raises. Again, you're either in that nice 4-point box or you're going into a half plank. And we're gonna go in 10 seconds. So you choose, get yourself ready. If you are gonna try this one, really make sure that core is braced. You've got a good gap between your knees as well. Toes down, off we go. Breathe out as you lift that arm. Engage that core. Really brace that core for me. It's not just pulling your tummy in, we talk about this all the time. It is really engaging that core, getting those muscles working again, okay? They've been put under so much pressure in pregnancy. 8 seconds, that's it. And one, lovely. Okay, sit back, we're gonna go into our stretching. So, onto your knees, and I want you to walk yourself forwards nice and gently. Just lying down, put your head down. Relax your body into the mat. Lovely, okay, come on up. Like everyone else's garden, there's a lot of garden work going on around me, so apologies if you can hear that. I want one hand up to the sky, look up if you can, even eyes closed, and then thread it through, bringing that shoulder down, holding it there. Lovely. Back to centre, other side, up we go, all the way through, bring it down. Just letting that back twist through, a nice stretch. Lovely. Come back to centre. We'll just do a couple of cat-cows. So tuck that chin, tuck that tailbone. Up we go. And then breathe out and drop down. And again. seated and put our feet together. And if you can, put your hands on your toes. If you can't, then your hands on your ankles are absolutely fine, okay? Just holding that stretch, just stretching down our inner thighs, okay? As low as those knees will go. And if you can, hold on to those toes and lean into it slightly with a nice flat back, not curving over. We've got the ball pit out. It's gonna come back now. Okay, one leg straight, leaning forwards if you can. If you've got a resistant band or a tea towel to hand, then I want you to use that as well. Just get that out of the way. So you can put that over your foot and then just pull back, okay? Nice and strong. Keeping that upper back nice and straight, but still getting the stretch in that calf. I am sweating sun cream. It is so warm out here. Amazing. Definitely not complaining. Okay, and swap over. I'm gonna change the music in 1 second. It's gone a bit intense. So keep that stretch there for me. Keep holding the stretch. Hold that stretch, and then I want you to do both together now. So both together, reaching down, or again, using that band. Whatever you feel is right. Okay, let's put something a little bit more calming on. Right, I want one leg across, straight leg arm, link, and then either hand by your side, if that's enough, or at the bottom of your back, looking over your shoulder. Pulling this leg in, your feet are all in your glutes. We've used our glutes a lot with this, with the squats and with the good mornings. Holding it there. Lovely. Okay, and swap over. Isn't it there? Lovely. Okay, let's do our upper body. So link those hands together, push out. Nice stretch. We're gonna go up. And we're gonna go over. Just holding it there. Nice gentle stretch all down your torso. And then come back to centre and we'll go to the other side. Brilliant. Okay, I want you to do the same stretch we did at the beginning. So link those hands behind, put them by your bottom, lift them up, open that chest, put that chin back. And really lift them up so you're opening that chest fully. Okay? Just hold it there, some nice deep breaths. And that'll be our stretching done. Lovely, okay. Roll the shoulders back and then roll them forwards. Lovely. Right, we'll do a little bit of pelvic floor now. So we're gonna do a seated pelvic floor today. So I'll just turn this down a little bit so you can hear me nicely. So it's a nice seated pelvic floor and I want you to just gently and just take a nice deep breath in. So nice deep breath in. And as you breathe out, I want you to stop it. So the best way to describe it is to stop yourself from trumping. So that is the easiest way to describe pelvic floor exercises. So as you breathe in, nice and relaxed, fill that tummy with air, fill all your lungs with air, and then as you release, I want you to stop yourself from trumping, but do not engage your glutes, okay? I don't want those glutes firing, I don't want you going up and down like this, so nice and gently. Now it's really, really hard to know if you're doing it right when I'm not physically there, but if you try and just stop yourself, so it's the stopping yourself from trumping and stopping yourself from having a win, that is your pelvic floor engaging, okay, at basic level. So get yourself nice and comfortable, and obviously you don't have to sit like this, you can lie down as well. That's the easiest way to do pelvic floor exercises, actually lying down. So nice deep breath in. And then breathe out and engage without squeezing those glutes, holding it there. And breathe in and release slowly. And again, breathe out and engage full pelvic floor all the way in. So you're lifting up and forwards to your pubic bone, all the way. And then breathe in and release. And breathe out and engage. And breathe in and release. Lovely. And breathe out and engage. Excellent. And one more. Breathe in and release. And breathe out and engage. Okay, this time we're going to do five fast. So we're going to do three of these and then we're going to do one long one to finish. So by five fast, what I mean is you take that nice deep breath in and then as you breathe out, you engage and you release and you engage and you release and you engage and you release. We'll do four, okay? So five's quite a lot for the first stage of postnatal. So we'll do four in that breath. So nice and relaxed again. Don't let those glutes get involved. Nice deep breath in. And then breathe out. Engage, release. Engage, release. Engage, release. Engage, release. Lovely. Breathe in. And breathe out. Engage, release. Engage, release. Engage, release. Engage, release. Breathe in. And breathe out. Engage, release. Engage, release. Engage, release. Engage, release. 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 Well done. Okay, nice deep breath in. We're going to do one long, slow engagement to finish with a really slow release. So, nice deep breath in. And breathe out. Engage nice and slowly. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and breathe in and release even slower. Breathe in, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Brilliant, well done. Okay, we're going to do some hip mobility now. So I'm just going to grab a quick drink. Get yourselves comfortable for this one. We're down on the mat again for this one, okay? So hopefully you can see me okay. I'm pretty sure you can. It's quite hard to see the screen in this light. Well, what we're going to do, first one. So you can get really stiff in your hips without realising. So a lot of the time, I personally find that my hips get quite stiff and I don't realise, and then my knees start to ache a little bit more, or my lower back plays up, and then I do some nice hip openers and some nice stretching my hip flexors, and then everything loosens up. So that's why I like to include different areas of stretching and mobility, just to make sure that you are stretching everything that you can. Now, in motherhood, your body, you are moving in different ways all the time, and your hips can get really, really tight, especially as they are moving and changing as well. So they have moved and changed in pregnancy, and obviously then they have moved and expanded within birth as well. So you've got that massive change of the whole impact on them through pregnancy, and then in birth as well, they open up, and we won't go into it today, but they are unbelievable what your pelvis does and what all the muscles around it do, and the relaxing that has come in, all the stretching that goes on for the muscles to allow your pelvis to open slightly to allow that baby to come out. So, and that doesn't matter what type of birth you've had, because all that happens all the way up to labour, okay? And then in labour, they will move even more. Even if you end up with an emergency C-section, for example, you may have gone through all of that and then had the emergency C. So your hips still do all that movement, whatever type of birth you've had. And just sitting, so general life, just sitting, moving, lifting, up and down, just general picking children up, moving around, your hips take a lot more than what you think, and they're such a stability area of the body. It's really important to make sure they're mobile and that they're stretching. So the first one we're going to do is a really basic hip rotation. We're going to do six, so we've got hip rotations, a nice joint rotation, and then we've got some butterfly stretches, And a slight adaptation on that, and we've got some nice stepping forward hip openers and a pigeon stretch. Okay, so the first one we're going to do is go into a 4-point kneeling, hands under shoulders, knees under hips, toes nice and relaxed, and then I want you to go backwards first, that's the easiest way to go, and then go round, so bring those hips forwards, dropping them back down. So we're going to go both ways, because you might find that more than likely, one side of your pelvis will be tighter than the other. So bringing it round, make massive circles with your bottom, okay? So what I want you to do, really draw really big circles with your bottom. Round and round, okay? We're going to go the other way. Nice deep breaths as you do. Lovely, just keep rotating. Okay, last one, come back to centre. Lovely. I want you on your back now, so I'm going to go here so my head goes into shade, so I'm not blinded by that lovely sunshine. Now, legs nice and flat, okay? So lying down nice and flat. Then I want you to bend your left leg. So you bend your left leg up like this, you get your right leg, and you cross it over. So this is quite a nice glute stretch that we do quite a lot. But what we're going to do here is we're going to bring this knee and we're going to bring it forwards and back. So towards you, so towards your heart, and then back the other way. Okay, so just bring it in and out. Keeping this leg nice and steady, in and out. Not masses of movement, but just making sure you've got that. So you do about 10 of those. So about 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10, and then we're going to stretch, so push, making sure that stretches out, and if it's not, you can lift this leg to feel it that bit more. Okay, holding it there, 5 more seconds, we're going to go into those movements again, and off we go. Making sure our left glute stays on the floor, up and down. You may feel like your pelvis needs to click when you're doing this. It should loosen everything up. Okay, one more, and then I want you to stretch. So stretching that one there, pushing back. And if you do need that deeper stretch, lift your left leg up. Brilliant. Okay, we're going to swap sides. So, right leg bent, left leg over. And then we're going to start with the mobility. So, bring that knee in, push it back out. Bringing it in, pushing it back out. I've just got my hands there for a bit of support. So, I'm not coming all the way up. So, my ankle is staying on my leg, okay? My ankle's not lifting. These are so nice to be doing in the sunshine. 3, 2, and 1. Okay, stretch, so pushing it away from you. Pushing it away, and if you need that deep stretch, lift this leg up like this, and push away in that way. Lovely. So keep stretching. Okay, let's do those mobility again. So bringing it in and back out, in and back out. Just rocking that knee back and forth. Lovely. That's it, keep going. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, we're gonna stretch it out. So again, push away from you. Nice deep breaths as you do it. Just letting yourself relax. You should be able to go a little bit further with this stretch the second time round. Okay, deep breath in and breathe out. Exhale, both legs down. Lovely. Okay, come back to seated, back to centre. Now we do this stretch, the butterfly one, quite a lot. in class because it's just an area that a lot of people don't end up stretching, but it is linked to our hip flexors. So what I want you to do is hold onto your feet if you can. If you can't, just hold onto your heels. I want you to bring those knees in and back down. Just up and down, just butterfly, okay? So 10, 9, 8, 7, as far as I go, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now obviously if any of these don't feel right, I should have said that at the beginning, please don't push your body in that way if it doesn't feel right. Okay, so we're just going to do another 10 of those and bring it in. So 10, 9, 8, 7. Keep going. 2 and 1. Lovely. Okay, so the next one is you're just going to bring those feet further forwards. So those are as close to your bottom as you could. Now we're just going to go that little bit further forward and do exactly the same. But I want your hands to be behind you, okay? So just put your hands behind you, just so you lean back slightly, and then you bring those knees in and back down, in and back down. Okay, so just these nice light stretches. And trust me, when you come back up to standing, you'll really feel the difference. If you add a few extra glute stretches in as well, you will really feel these. So these are mobility. This one's a little bit more strengthening, but it is still nice mobility. So we'll do 10, 9, 8, keep going. 1. Lovely. Okay, we're going to do another set of those. And then we've got 2 more stretches where we're going to do on either side. So 10, 2 and 1. Lovely. Okay, so bring those knees together. As always, if you are early posing, make sure those knees are coming together. And we're going to step forward. So we do this one quite a lot as well when we're doing our sessions. So you step it forward, use a wall if you need to. And then we're going to just rock our bum back. So we tilt backwards. So doing our posterior and anterior stretching. So we're going to go backwards, into forwards, and leave it there. So we don't want to lean all the way over like this. You want to stay nice and upright and lean into it. And then, oh, you'll feel it there, right in your hip flexor. Holding it there, okay? Once we've got that nice stretch, I want you to lift. So I've got my left leg forward, so I'm going to lift my left arm up, and I'm going to lean over to my right side. Now I'll just open up the other side slightly. Swap sides. So that leg goes forwards. Again, always rebalance, so go backwards and forwards, leaning into it, making sure that knee doesn't go over the toes. If you're feeling that, just move that front leg forwards a little bit, okay? Making sure you're nice and comfortable. You really will feel this one. It's quite a deep stretch, okay? Just go as far as is comfortable for you. Okay, and then when you're ready, I'm on my right side, so I'm lifting my right arm up, dropping my left, and coming over to the side. Making sure I'm not losing that centre, so I'm still nice and balanced. Lovely, come back to centre, drop down, bring your knees together, and then come back to seated, because we're now going to do the pigeon. So I'm going to start with my right leg forwards on this one, which means my left leg is nice and straight and back. So it's very hard on this hard floor on my knees. Bring this forward, I'm never very elegant at doing this one. Cross over, so if everyone can see that, cross this leg over, so this heel is by your left knee, and then you drop yourself down, okay? Flat foot, I know you can't see my back foot, but it's nice and flat. And then if that's enough for you, okay, stay there. If not, lower yourself down. Now always remember, if you are in that 0 to 6 month bracket, you will still have relaxing in your system. So don't overstretch your body, okay? Just make sure you're still within those realms of what you were pre-pregnancy. And don't think, oh, this is great, I can get all the way down. I couldn't do that before. Because we don't want to overstretch those ligaments and tendons. So just holding that there. Lower yourself down even more if you can. If you can't, please stay upright. Nice deep breaths when you're there. And then breathe in. And exhale. Come out of it.
And I want you to swap over. Okay, so this is a bit that is never elegant with me. The swapping over. Make sure that leg goes across and down. Bring this knee back as far as it'll go. Nice and straight. And then lower yourself down. So obviously if you were here, that's absolutely fine, okay? I can feel that stretch there. Nice deep stretch, I can feel it. But I'm gonna just bring myself down a little bit more. And then possibly even a little bit further, okay? So if you can, go down to the mat. Really feeling it in those hips now. Nice deep breaths. One more deep breath in. And exhale, come back to centre. Nice and gently. Well done, everyone. Okay, I hope you enjoyed that session and that nice bit of hip mobility. You should feel a lot looser in the hips now when you come back to seated. I know I do now I'm sat here, but standing up I'll feel even better. So I hope you enjoyed the session. It was a nice warm one today. This told me I worked hard anyway. If you have any questions, as always, please give me a shout. Just drop them in the bottom. Thank you for all of those who have viewed and said hello. I hope you are enjoying this weather as much as I am, and get out for those walks, enjoy this time. I'm pretty sure we can see one person now, can't we, from another household, socially distanced. So that is fantastic for well-being, which is really, really good. Make sure you're trying to get your exercise and drink lots and lots of water after this session. So if you've just done it, I haven't drunk enough, I'm going to drink all of that and another one of these before I go out for my walk, because it is warm. So make sure you drink lots, take care, and I'm back on here on Wednesday for the 6 month plus session at 1 o'clock. Otherwise, I'll be back here on Monday for 0 to 6 months. So take care, everyone. Have a lovely week. Any questions, give me a shout. Bye.